Hi. This is probably the most popular module used by makers to charge a lithium-ion battery. It is based on the TP4056 IC, which is a constant current constant voltage linear charger designed for single-cell lithium-ion batteries. The module is efficient, space-saving, and very useful for integrating rechargeable batteries into DIY projects. After using this module for several years, I've discovered three key points that I hope will help you make the most of it. In the description you will find links to articles that helped me in the production of this video. And if you watch until the end of the video, there's a small bonus waiting for you. Hi, I'm Dario and I'm a maker. Please show your support by clicking the like button.
Tip number 1.
There are two types of modules available on the market. One has only the charger chip and board, while the other has three chips on board. Although the smaller one is cheaper, the larger one is safer and has some interesting features. On this board, you can find the TP4056, the DW01A battery protection IC, and the 8205 a dual MOSFET. These two ICs are responsible for protecting both the battery and the circuit by providing short circuit detection, overcurrent detection, overcharge detection, and over-discharge detection. Having these protections helps to safeguard both the battery and our circuit. However, it's important to note that this module doesn't offer reverse polarity protection. Therefore, it's crucial to connect the battery poles correctly to avoid any damage. A redesign of the circuit to incorporate this feature would be an advantage. If you'd like a video on this topic, please let me know in the comments.
Tip number 2.
According to the datasheet, the TP4056 allows you to adjust the maximum charge current. Please note that commercial modules typically have a maximum charge current of 1 ampere, which is suitable for charging batteries with capacities greater than 3000 mAh. I usually set the maximum charge current equal to 30% of the battery capacity. For example, for this 310 mAh battery, I recommend setting the maximum charge current to around 100 mAh. This will ensure safe and efficient charging. To adjust the charging current, you can easily substitute the resistor called R-Prog in the datasheet. This table displays the main values that can be set. If you're interested, you can check out my earlier video titled DIY Coin Battery Charger to see how I made a 30 mAh coin battery charger. It's a simple process. I usually insert a connector instead of a resistor so that I can easily change the resistor on the circuit and charge batteries with different capacities using the same module.
Tip number 3.
To keep your battery healthy, it is best not charge it and use it at the same time. It is not safe to connect a load to the battery while the module is charging. According to the datasheet, the TP4056 finishes charging when the current equals the programmed max charge current divided by 10. If you connect a load while charging your battery, the IC may detect a higher current than what's actually being used to charge the battery, so the module may never terminate the charging process and potentially damage the battery. There are various circuits on the web to solve this problem, but I have never personally tested one. If you are curious about how to solve this problem, post in the comments and I will make a video dedicated to this solution.
Bonus tip.
Making this video, I noticed something on the datasheet that I hadn't noticed before. Did you know that there is a designated pin for connecting an NTC thermistor to monitor the battery's temperature? This means that if battery's temperature is too high or too low, charging will be suspended. The temperature sense function can be disabled by grounding the temp pin. Of course, the commercial module in question does not have this feature enabled. After checking the schematic on the datasheet, it seems that the values of the resistors R1 and R2 are not specified. But it would be nice to find the right components to add this feature as well. Feel free to leave a comment if you would like a video demonstrating this process. We've reached the end. If you found this video helpful or enjoyable, please consider subscribing to my channel. Ciao, ciao.